I would like to congratulate and thank everybody for making this con happen. Guys, congratulations. Thank you for volunteering and making this con happen. And everybody who's traveled thousands of miles from some other countries, welcome to India. And I am Neetu Morwani, currently working as a developer at Acquia. And I'll be talking about features and CMI in Drupal 8. And the name of my session is Features versus CMI, the battle for Drupal 8. So guys, every once in a while, a revolutionary and a phenomenal product comes in the market. And this time it is our very own Drupal 8, coupled with super awesome and fantastic features. So guys, before I start with the technical and all the geeky talks, I would like to know how many of you have used Features module in Drupal 7 before? Oh, we have quite a good number. And how many of you have explored Drupal 8 a bit? Oh, I have super smart audience. Okay, so can anybody come up with the usage of Features module? Anybody? Can you come up with something about Features module? Yeah.
It's mainly just to actually transport your features into another thing.
Okay. Anybody else?
Yeah. There will be nodes or view or all the configuration or the node can be transported between your sites.
Yeah. Great. Okay. Anybody else? Yeah.
Exporting configuration between different environments. Any type of configuration.
Yeah. Awesome. Yes, so I will summarize what everybody has said. So, Features module is used for moving the configuration from one server environment to another. So, we use Features module for deployment purpose. So now, we all are on the same page. I think we can start. Everybody knows what Features module is all about. I think we can start about the main talk. So yeah, yesterday I was just going around the campus and I came across few students, and that reminded me of my school and college days. I remember my teachers, I remember my mentors, I remember my friends, I remember the fun times I've had. And the last thing that I remember is the video lessons which I learned through some video capsules. So guys, everything we learn via video capsules leaves an imprint on our heart. So I would be glad if you guys remember what we learned in this session. So probably I'll just start with a video here. So guys, this is a very funny video. Nothing technical here. There is a message here. Anybody got the message? What this video was all about? Come on, I'm not expecting you to say that guy loves the girl. No, I'm expecting a meaningful message you guys got from this. Yes.
You should bundle up the things.
Yes.
Unless you go for a single item when you need it.
Yes. So, there are certain things which are meant for bundling. And what if we do not bundle them? As you just saw, we'll end up in situations which we do not want to be in there. So in order to avoid certain situations, let's start bundling up things. So yes, we learn about configuration management and features module, and what are the enhancements made in features module in Drupal 8, and what are the differences there, and how Drupal 8 code is awesome, super awesome with features module. So guys, when Drupal 8 was still in the development phase, there was a lot of fuss about CMI. Is anybody aware of what is CMI? Yes.
Application
Management Initiative. Yes, and what is the end result of Configuration Management Initiative? Yeah, so CMI stands for Configuration Management Initiative, and as the end result of CMI, we have developed a configuration management system that is used for moving the configuration from one environment to another. So there were certain pain points which every Drupal 7 developer has been grappling with, and configuration management helps their developers to solve those pain points. It also facilitates the ease movement of configuration from one server environment to another. And as I just said, that there are certain pain points which every Drupal 7 developer has been grappling with. We will see what pain points have been resolved now by the configuration management system. So yes, configuration management system has a consistent approach for storing the configuration. Now guys, can anybody come up with the number of ways in which the configuration was stored in Drupal 7? Where were we storing the configuration in Drupal 7?
Yes.
In database. But what else? What in database? What? There were certain tables. Yes. Was there any other way apart from system, variables table?
Settings.php.
Settings.php again saved the entire configuration variables tables. Anything else?
Your dollar $conf variables.
Yeah, correct. Yes. So there are multiple ways of storing the configuration in Drupal 7. So every module has to come up with their own way of storing the configuration. There were modules who made their own tables. And there were modules who stored configuration in variables table. And there were configuration in C tools. Exported via features. So there were multiple ways of storing the configuration in Drupal 7. So whenever I will just share my experience. Whenever I was made to work on a new project, it was a pain for me to see where the configuration actually resides, because there was not a single way. I had to check the variables table. I had to check the other tables module was providing. So there were multiple ways. Now in configuration management, what configuration management has done? We just have one way to store the configuration, and that is YAML files. Now, is anybody aware what is YAML file? What? Yes. YAML. Yet another markup language, yes. So YAML is a format of files, and it is human readable. And the configuration is stored in key pair format in YAML files, and it is human readable. You can just read the YAML file and you will see what the configuration is all about, what it stores. So yes, with the help of configuration management, there is only one way to store the configuration, and that is YAML files. So this is the one screenshot of YAML file. I hope it is visible. It says that name large. So this is a YAML file of our image type. As you can see, it has the name, it has a dimension. So just having a look at the YAML file, we can clearly find out what the configuration is all about, what it has. So now everything is YAML. Tables, C tools, variable tables, everything is YAML file now in Drupal 8. Yeah, so the next problem which was there in Drupal 7 is imagine you have hit the code freeze, and there are certain things, there are certain changes that you have made, but you cannot push anything on the other deployment environments. How do you take the code there? Is there any way to make your changes there on the environment? To take the local changes from on the other environments, development environment, staging environment, is there a way?
Features.
But you have hit the code freeze. What else? I'm the client. I do not want any code to go on the environment now. Is there any way? You have to do things manually. But is it feasible to do things manually on several environments? It is not feasible. right? But we have better staging of better configuration staging management system in Drupal 8 now. You have hit the code freeze. There are certain things that you want to move from one environment to another. You can just export the files from one environment and you can just import them on the other environment. Now I can see so many confusing faces here. Guys, don't worry, we'll see a demo here. Whatever I'm speaking, we'll see everything in the demo. How we can export YAML files from one configuration environment to another environment. Yeah, so after talking a lot about configuration management, what are the pros of configuration management, let's discuss how does this work. So has anybody seen the settings of PHP 5 of a Drupal 8 environment? Anybody guys? So did you notice a variable there, $config_directory? What is there? What does that variable contain? Anybody? Yeah.
Directory, which contains the configuration files.
Yes, yes. So my audience knows everything. Okay. So there is a variable called config directory, and it stores the path where my entire configuration is stored in the form of YAML files. If I have to take the configuration from one environment to another environment will scan that directory and import the configuration from that directory. So it has the path to the direct configuration directory. And just to make the things more easy, we developers believe in making things simpler, easier. So I've just renamed the directory. You can also rename the directory. In my case, I have just renamed it to same directory so that it makes more sense. Initially, it is something config_hash, but I have just renamed it to sync and have created a directory in the path, and it picks up everything from there. Okay, so let's see the demo here. What am I doing here? So the environment is a development environment, and I'm just changing a site name here.
Excuse me, can you turn off the lights please? You can see from back here.
Yes, sorry.
Can you turn off the lights? You cannot see from back here.
Okay, well, we can just turn the lights turned off. So, I'll just brief you about what is there in the video. So I'm just changing the site name and the slogan of my current one environment, dev environment, and I will be exporting the configuration, and I will be importing that configuration on the another environment, and you will see the changes being reflected on the next environment. Site.yml file will have all the configuration related to my site. I'll just copy the code. The environment is dev.local as you can see. I go on the next environment, and this is my site name which is there. Configuration management resides. It resides under development tab. I just go there. Just because I'm importing a single file, I'll click on single item there. I pasted my configuration there. There is a batch process that starts while importing the configuration. Once we have all the configuration, we'll see. Yeah, so successfully imported the configuration, and let's see the difference in the site name. Oh, so I have my new site name and slogan there. So yes. So guys, what we just saw in the video is that I exported the file from one environment and imported on the second environment, and my all the configuration changes which were there on the first environment are there in the second environment. Now, you just saw in the demo that I just, yeah.
So how will you work on a
multi-site environment? So basically, what is multi-site environment? You have everything in sites, sites folder. So over there, you can just import the configuration in under several domains. Every site will have a different layout, every site is a different database, right? So you just go on a different domain name, import the configuration there, and it will pick up everything from the same directory. What is there in the same directory? So if you are making a change, and if you're just copying that same directory under all the multi-site category, and you're importing it, your all multi-sites will have what is there in the same directory. So the same directory is the important key aspect here. Everything which is there in the same directory will be copied to the database. Yes.
So if you're on the common database, right?
Yeah.
So we can have a common database fixed, and then on that is how it will work actually. I could not see any kind of the DBA site selector over here.
Yeah.
I cannot choose any site over
here. Yeah, so this is what is there in the code. And probably Jeff, I think we can do something custom here to make this more expandable.
Yeah, so this is, she's on one site, so if there were multiple sites,
yeah.
She's still only importing configuration to one of the sites. So you can import it to each individual site. You have different configurations to import into different multi-site sites, you could do that.
Can that be automatic? Like, so there are like 100 sites. Is there something in code or some particular?
No. So for now, we do not have anything in code. But I think there will be some contributed modules, as this is a very common requirement to have a multi-site configuration. So this is just what is there. What does Drupal 8 provide out of the box? But yes, there will be contributed modules which will fulfill your requirement as well. Yeah.
Something for that.
Yeah.
Because I don't want to save the configuration
of the other. Yeah. So when Drupal 8 development was, yeah, 1 second. When Drupal 8 development was in progress, there was one issue which everybody was working on. And the issue said that I want my default configuration to be stored in files. Right. But then we later on decided that we'll be saving the configuration in the database. But yes, just making a change in the settings.php file, you can say that I want to make my default configuration stored in the form of YAML files. So yes, you can do that. Yes.
Are you able to roll back? Will you use?
Yes, yes, we'll see that. I have a next slide. So yes, these are just the screenshots. What I did from the export tab, as you can see, full archive and single item there. We can export the entire configuration directory and import it on some other environment. We also have an option to export just a single file, which we just did. Now, screenshot for importing, we have, again, same thing goes here. We can import the full configuration directory. Now, what is the result of exporting the full configuration directory? When you do the full export, full archive export, what do you get? What is the end result? You get the tar.gz file, which you get as the end result, which you place, it has the configuration YAML files. You place that, you unzip it, you place it in the same directory, and you are good to go. And the good thing is that this directory can also be version controlled. And I hope, I make this assumption that everybody is aware of this, since we cannot just take a configuration from one server environment to another without just version controlling it. But I'm just repeating it again and just telling it that yes, we can version control this directory under Git or any version control system that you guys use. And the next tab is the synchronized tab, the question that you asked. Over here, you will see all the differences. So there are certain things which exist in the database, and there are certain things which exist in the code. So you will see a list of everything there, and what all you can just check the items what you want to import, what are the things that are removed, what are the things that have been added, what are the things have been changed. So just you can see everything, and you can make the choice, and you can import them. So this synchronized tab will let you see what is the difference, what are the new files that you have imported, and what are the new files that have gone as a result of pulling in the latest code. And
but once that is imported, are you able to move back, like features? If you disable the feature, you go back?
No. So what is there in the code, once you've imported it is there in the database, you cannot roll back. You have to do the changes again. Yeah.
The other way around is you're doing version control. So you could also use that to go back to the previous
version. Yeah, so everything is version controlled. Yeah.
Of files.
Yeah, so everything is possible with Git, but Drupal, then when we are talking about Drupal 8 core, once the changes are there in the database, you have to make those changes again. Yes. Yeah, so now everybody is aware of the benefits of configuration management. Now everybody knows how it works, but still, you may end up getting yourself disappointed. And the reason for your disappointment can be the UUID. So guys, do you know what UUID is? Anybody? Yeah.
Unique identifier.
Yeah, universally unique identifier. Okay, and this is the full form of UUID, but what is the significance of UUID?
Every site is a different, has a unique identifier.
So thank you. So whenever you do a site install, there is a fresh UUID which is associated with the site, which identifies that site. Now when I said that you can move the configuration from one server environment to another, what did I mean? I meant that the second environment should be the clone of the first environment. The UUID should be same. Right. So yes, and so we can see if the UUID of destination site is equal to the UUID of the source site, CMI will work, otherwise it will fail. So yes, let's step back a bit and remember what you all guys said, what we all came up with the definition of features. We said that feature is used for moving configuration from one server environment to another. But was it intended to do that? Was it built for moving the configuration from one server environment to another?
No.
No, it wasn't. Yeah, so we'll talk about features as well. But guys, there is one more thing which you should all cheer about. We have the Drupal support for this as well, for configuration management. Now, do you consider, how many of you believe in better user experience? Everybody believes in better user experience, right? Now, do you consider this as a good approach? I export the configuration, I get the tar.gz file, I unzip the tar.gz file, I then manually copy and paste it in the sync directory. It is too much of a pain, right? And we believe in making things faster, better. So yes, we have a Drupal support as well. Let's see what I just did here. Probably this is a long video, but I'll just make it faster. And this video has everything. How you can version control the code, how you can export the code, how you can import the code. This has everything. So I'll just fast forward it, since I'm just changing the configuration, I'm just changing the name of the file. As you can see the environment.
gentleman asking about automating this.
Yes.
So Drush can be used for automation.
Yeah.
And can, I think we can also make custom Drush commands just following the process.
Yeah, you can make custom Drush commands, but why would we make it when they are already available, right?
Yeah, but like there are for number of sites,
yeah.
I have to write
yeah.
a script. Then
you can, yeah.
Then
yeah.
in that case. I'm
yes. So I have added a new field to a content type. The reason why I did this because you will see new YAML files which will be added. So I've changed the site name, slogan, added a new field to a content type. The field is there. The field is the event date field. Is it not clearly visible? Let me try. I think this is the full screen. Probably I can just say what am I doing here. I'm saving the configuration. And I have added a new field in the content type. I can just repeat everything what is happening there in the video. I see that my article content type has a new field. And what I did here, I did drush config export, which will export entire configuration into the sync directory. I will do the git status now. So this is drush config export. As you can see, that there are new files added and there are files modified. The one in the green are the new files added. Now, does anybody know why the new files got added? Yeah, because I added a new field, right? And every field has two YAML files in Drupal 8. Yeah, so the new files were added. I'm adding them under git. So as you can see, the status, git status. The other remaining files which are on track are useless. I'll probably just add the two files. The one that I'm highlighting here. Under git, I've added those two files. I can see the new files and I can see the modified files under the git diff. I've committed the code, I am pushing the code so that I can pull the code on the next environment. So this is my next environment. I go under configuration management screen and I can see the differences here. What are the differences? But I do not want to use the UI. I want to use the brush command again for importing things here. I am aware of only two commands, drush export and drush config import. You mean to say that if I just want to see the differences?
No, I mean.
What do you mean by the sync here?
Sync means when you create a new field, you have a new configuration on your dev server.
Yeah.
You want to push this to stage.
Yeah.
So you do drush config sync your dev server as your stage server from
I am not aware of this, I'm sorry.
No, I just
yeah, yeah. Probably, I know, I have never seen this. There are only two commands which I'm aware of. One is for exporting and one is for importing. If you do not want to do this again and again, probably you can just make a default configuration to be stored in YAML files, and that way your whatever changes you are doing, it will be there in your YAML files.
If you would create one file, one PL in one of the dev environments,
yeah.
And you try to export that one,
yeah.
It's the same one, but with a different PL tag. So let's say you have a numeric one, and then you want to change it as a text, does it work?
Can you please repeat? I have one field. I have created
yes,
one field.
Okay, at the beginning you have the same both development sites, and in one of them you recreate that part field.
Okay.
With a different tag.
With a different tag.
Yeah.
Okay. The same field with a different tag.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think so that you can do that. If there is a field which is associated with a content type. And you want to reuse that field, the entire configuration will be the same because you are reusing the field there.
Yeah, but if you want to change the type of that field, how do you do it?
No.
So
I don't think you can change the type of the field since the data is already there in the field. Yeah.
Well, so what will happen if you import a field with the same name as an existing field on the site which may have different UUIDs, then it will delete the field on the incoming site, but it will tell you it's going to do that.
Okay.
Yes.
Because
you cannot
manage that, so
that's
my question.
So in case if we change the label of that particular field, will it be able to move the changes?
Yeah, label is something that you can change. There is one field which is associated with a content type and you want to reuse the field, we do change the labels. Label is something that you can change, but what you cannot change is the configuration, is the type. Because there may be some value which exists in the fields, right? And I do not want to lose my data. That's it.
So if the two teams are working on the same particular kind of code, so with ability be able to, we are able to see from the interface that all the things, whatever the changes one team is doing and the other team is working on that. So can it be possible to check what all changes have been done by a set of particular
If everything is under Git, I think you can just check out on that commit IDs.
Not from the perspective of Git, from this.
No. There is no such functionality in configuration management, so where you can see what the other team is doing. And probably we can just build a custom code for this. I am not sure how are you comparing with installation profile with configuration management system, because what is the use of installation profile? Installation profile is just a profile. We have standard and minimal profiles, which mean that there are certain set of modules which will be installed while you do the site install, right? And configuration management is entirely a different concept.
Given the default values can be exported from your version or the other.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter. There can be new version or new distribution. So features, as I said, like certain variables can be written in your command. And then again, when it comes to the installation profile, you will have a default configuration along the module. So that's our entire feature. So here we are talking about only the CMI, we are talking about only the
No, configuration management has all the configuration, whether it's your content type, whether it's your variables. By the way, we no longer have variables under Drupal 8, we have configuration. So any configuration which exists on your site, you can take it from one environment to another using configuration management system. So I'm not only talking about just one type of configuration, all the configuration which is there on your site. And in Drupal 8, configuration no longer belongs to user, configuration belongs to a site. Right? So all the configuration which is there, you can take from one environment to another, and it can be controlled and managed by configuration management system. So when you do the site install, you see that there are two options. One is standard and one is minimal, right? So those two are the installation profiles. And what is specified in installation profile is the number of modules. So this installation profile will have X number of modules, this installation profile will have Y number of Y modules, and that is what installation profile is all about.
So that we can upgrade it, and upgrade it more than
probably the recommended way is configuration management.
All the issues in one side, like let's say Drupal numbers, and then everyone wants the same way. When we move to the next version, we do other.
I think this is the solution.
So there are 100 ways of doing a thing, but there is only one ideal way of achieving it correctly. And if we do not want a project to be in mess, let's go with the ideal solution, right?
One question.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm a newbie to Drupal 8, so you were talking about UUID for one configuration site to another, copying that when you are exporting or importing the configuration. So if we are having two environments and we are having the same UUID for both of them, then are we losing the configuration of one environment?
No. So if you are having two environments of a size, it is a mandatory thing that the UUIDs will be same.
Okay.
And you cannot lose the configuration. If you are making a change, you are git under, you are making that change under git, you are tracking that under git, you are taking that change into the second environment, you are importing it there, there is no way of losing the configuration. If that is something which is intentional, for example, I change my site name, so if you mean that my previous site name will be lost, yeah, but it is not losing, it is something that I want, it is my requirement, right? Hope that answers your question.
Yeah, somehow.
Okay.
Let's say I have 20 items to be imported.
Yeah.
So in such case, I have to do individually, right? Say PDF, or is there any option?
So there are two ways. Either you can export the files single item, right? And there was one more way, which said full archive. You can take the full archive dump of the configuration which is there in the site. So in that way, your all the configuration which is there in your site will be dragged. Guys, let's speed up a bit. I think it's 12:10 and I have to complete this by 12:30. Can you please come up with the question at the end of the session?
Yeah.
Okay. Probably have last class 5 minutes or 10 minutes for this Q&A. So here, I was just talking about the Drush support that we can export and import the configuration with the Drush as well. So guys, yes. Why do you still think that I'm still standing here and talking to you? After having so many questions and answers, I know this is a very stupid question to ask, but why do you think I'm still standing here talking to you since I've covered everything in configuration management system? Now you guys are all pro of configuration management system. Why do you think I'm still standing here and talking to you? Yes, yes. Although we have had a lot of discussion about features, but yes, we'll talk more about features. So, we adopted features-based deployment workflow in Drupal when we were working with Drupal 7, right, in the Drupal 7 sites. But as I just said that, it was never meant for deploying things. It was never meant for taking configuration from one server environment to another. If we just go back to the history, how many of you know that what was features in developed for and what was the requirement, why it was initially developed? Anybody? If you, yes? Yeah, it was, but was, what was the requirement of the client and which client it was? So if we just go back to the history, when we were working on, yes, Gulab, yes.
Okay, we got features because we wanted like export a particular functionality. And suppose you got a blog and I want to export some functionality from a blog. So I can export the content type. I can export the piece and everything in that piece of code. And someone else, any one of you guys can just import that and enable that, and the blog will be there.
Yeah. So it was basically for bundling things, which you also said. But it was mainly developed for OpenATM distribution. Then there was a requirement that we have to bundle up things and we have to take things from one project to another. When I say project, I mean totally a different site. I do not mean one environment, I mean a different project. So yes, it was mainly developed for OpenATM distribution and in Drupal 6 days. So yes, we still need features in Drupal 8. since we will be using features for bundling things now. We will not be using features for deployment. So, how many of you have faced problems with features module? Oh my god, everybody. And the result of it can be seen on Drupal.org, the long issue queue of features module. Yes, so can anybody come up with a bug which is there in the features module, but it is not actually a bug, but you face a problem? Anybody?
Performance.
A problem. And?
If you add one view particular on a particular feature, then you cannot add that particular view into another feature.
Yes.
Then it will create a conflict, then you have to resolve the conflict.
Okay, anything better?
You can't report
Yeah, so probably I'll just say one problem which I think everybody might have us have faced, and we considered it as a bug, but it was never a bug. So there is a content type with a feature, and the content type is featureized. Now the requirement is there are a number of fields in that content type. Now the requirement is that I do not need a field anymore. I delete that field. The next step is I update the feature. My updated feature code goes on the next environment. I rework the feature so that I have the code which is there in the features. My database is in sync with the code, what is there in the code. Now, what do you think? What is the end result of reworking the feature? Can somebody speak louder?
Field will still be in the database.
Yes, field will be there in the database. And how many of you thought that it is a bug when you started working on features module in the initial days? Yes. Even I myself thought of it as a bug, but it is not a bug since feature assumes that there is a data in that field and it will not delete that field. It was mainly not intended for deployments. It was made for bundling. And since we, people of community, started using it for deployment purpose, we ended up in being in situation where it took long hours in resolving things and see unforeseen situations. So I have a requirement to create a photo gallery. What all things do I need in a photo gallery? Yes, I need a content type, and that content type needs an image field. Right, I have the content now. Since after the content type, I have the content now. To display all the images, I need a view. But still, my site does not look good. What's still missing? Probably I need a slider. I'll change the slider to slideshow. Still, I do not find it interesting enough. I'll create a image style so that all the images are of a desired dimension. So we can add many things, and this requirement may go on, right? So it was features is intended for bundling things. You bundle content type, view, image style, everything in a feature, and you just make a feature out of it. There is one project. You take that. What is the end result of a feature? When I say that create a feature, what is the end result of it? We have a module, right? And there are various modules on V.O. We can just download and use them on any of our project. It is not a dependent thing, which will be a project-specific thing, right? So we have a module, we have a feature module, which we can just enable on some other site, and we will have content type with the image field view and everything there. So this was what feature was intended to. Okay. Now since we all are aware of what feature intended to do, it was used for bundling things. What are enhancements in Drupal 8 features? Is anybody aware of where feature module resides? Where is the UI of features module in Drupal 8? Anybody? Okay. So initially, there was one more tab under the configuration management screen, but now it is now updated to it just got updated recently. Previously it was with configuration management, and now it is admin, configuration, development and features. We have a new menu link under development tab, which is the result of features module. So I'll just talk about the enhancements quickly. What are the enhancements in feature 8 module? So yes, in Drupal 7 when I enabled features module, were there any pre-made features, guys? No. But in Drupal 8, the features are pre-made. And you can also configure it. So whenever you create, whenever you install a module, there will be features like article, page. So what is happening in the backend is features is detecting on based on configuration ki what the content types are there. And the number of content types and all its related configuration will be there in a feature. So yes, we have pre-made features in Drupal 8 now. You no longer have to create a new feature which will have article content type or a basic content type. You already have those. Yes, the next thing is bundles. How many of you are aware of the categorization which happens in features module? There are features, in one feature I have all the content types, in one feature I have all the views. I can configure it. There is a left tab which says views, which will have all the features related to views. There is one more left thing, I can create one more group of content type, it will have all the features with content type, although it is never a recommended approach to keep all the views in a feature, but I'm just taking this as an example so that things are clear now. So yes, the concept of bundles is same as it was in Drupal 7 of categorization. Yes, we have the concept of namespaces. Now, how many of you know that what is the concept of namespace? Why do we use namespace? Anybody? Yes. Yes.
We can save our code in different files which are differentiated with a name.
Yes. Anybody else?
The same class name can be used in different languages.
Yes. So I'll make it more clear. There is a module named ABC. There is one more module. Now what if I want to create one more module with the same name, ABC? Will I be able to do that in Drupal 7?
No.
No, but you can do that in Drupal 8. We have the concept of namespaces. So whenever I associate a namespace with a module, that module is categorized under that namespace. So I can have one more module with the same name but in the different namespace. So namespace prevents the collisions of the modules and of the names. So I have created a feature and I want to let's say I created a feature and I have a bundle called album. All the features which are related to album, this photo gallery functionality will be under that feature. So if the name of the feature was ABC, now after making it under one bundle, it will be bundle name underscore ABC. So yes, namespace is prefixed before the feature's name. Yes, this is one of the best things of features module Drupal 8, that production and state sites need not have the features module. You just need features module on one environment wherein you are creating features. Your production environment, your staging environment, or any other environment where you want the configuration to go. You do not need features module there, just burdening the site. No, you just need feature on your first environment. The last and the main important thing is modular UI. What if I do not want my site builder to access any of my features? I do not want to give my site builder any permission to access features. I just want my developer to have access over all the features but not the site builder. We have a module features UI which I can just turn it off if I do not want that anybody to access that UI. So yes, as I told you before that we got one more tab under configuration management screen of features, but it is no longer there. It is now moved to admin configuration development and features, but previously it was under the feature under the configuration management system. Yeah. So the reason the slide is there, it shows the conflict. I have created a new feature and I have included the YAML files of which belong to article content type. And as a result of it, I get conflict. Why did was there any occurrence when we got the conflict in Drupal 7 features? Yes. When I tried including the configuration which is already there in some other feature into my new feature, I will get the conflict. So same thing happened here. All the article and basic page related configuration are there in the pre-made feature, and I tried including them in my new feature, and as a result of which I got this conflict. So this is just a snapshot of how my feature module will look like. It is the bundle, it is all the collection of YAML files. All the configurations are now YAML, everything is under YAML files, and there will be two directories, install and optional, which will have YAML files. Again, this is something which feature module will do for you. It will categorize few of the YAML files under optional and few of the YAML files under install directory. Okay. Guys, this is the last slide, and this is just a way to show that how Drupal 8 is super awesome, how it is fantabulous, and how it manages to solve things which Drupal 7 core did not do. So Drupal 7 core had out-of-the-box support, but with the help of features module, yes, we were able to accomplish certain things. There were only certain things which we were not able to accomplish with features module in Drupal 7, which was track configuration changes full site. We were not able to track all the configuration with features module. There were certain things which were not, for example, we can track variables with the help of strong arm, but there are certain things which feature no longer supports, which feature had no support of. So yes, and Drupal 8 has all the configuration. You can track all the configuration which is there in the site. The only thing which Drupal 8 core is not able and cannot handle is packaging configuration, and for that we have features module. So Drupal 8 core plus features and you're good to go. You can track all the configuration, you can package everything, you can track selected configuration, you can do everything. If you want to collaborate on the same project, yes, we were able to collaborate on the same project with the help of configuration management system. What if you want to collaborate on different projects? You can do that with the help of features. So yes, you can do everything with Drupal 8 core and features. And the last slide, guys, things were bundled up next time. Thank you, guys. Hope we learned something from this session. And if there are any questions you guys have, you can follow me up on Twitter. I have my website. You can get in touch with me on email. And I have my details written here, guys. I would be glad to solve your problems. Thank you. No.
Say a repeat question.
Yeah.
My question is, have you tried using that trust config import and export on different PHP versions?
Yes, can you please do it?
Have you tried importing those trust configurations
yeah.
on different PHP versions?
No, I haven't tried this. Because if I have one environment, if I have second environment, they will be on a single PHP version. Because there are chances that my site may break on some other PHP version.
But if you have, in case you have two servers, they can be on different PHP versions.
Yeah.
But there are chances of the site being break, right?
Yeah,
there are chances of site being broken.
Yeah.
But
so
at least the minimum requirement for Drupal 8 is greater than 5.5.9.
Mm-hmm.
So probably you have the greater version, so it shouldn't be a problem.
But it can be that.
Yeah, it can be, but then in that case we have to look manually, right? But with the possibilities of the only the few person, few functions are deprecated or
yeah.
something else.
And it's different than Drupal 7, where with Drupal 7 you were exporting PHP, and Drupal 8 you're exporting YAML.
Yeah, yes.
So.
Thank you guys, thank you Tim for answering the question. Thank you everybody. Yes.
You mentioned that we need features in Drupal 8.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Since you just saw the snapshot, what a feature module has, it just has YAML files, right? You enable a module, it is just a module. Like you enable the module, you will have all the configuration.
So it will be detected as a YAML.
Yes. Thank you guys.